So in this lesson, we will learn how to use colors in LaTeX. So there are four types of colors which we can use by their names. We don't have to define any colors if you want to use color by names. First of all, there are some base colors. For these colors, we will use only this color package without any option of this package, because in these brackets we put options. From here to here, we put some option. We can put some options. So these base colors are available if we use this color package and without using any option. So these are always available. So there are around 19 colors which are available to us. I will show you in a minute. Then there are colors which are available if we use this option, dvipsnames, with a command like this, use package, color, and then we say use names, comma, dvipsnames. Then we are able to use these colors. So there are a lot of colors which we can add to these colors. We get access to dvipsnames option, colors. Then there are few other color names available to us, which are svgnames. So they are more than dvipsnames, a lot of colors available if we use this option. But this option is only available to xcolor package. So dvipsnames option available to color and xcolor package. So these are the two main packages which we use whenever we want to use colors in LaTeX. So initially it was color package, then they added some more colors, and xcolor is the more advanced package. So, and with using svgname option in xcolor package, we get access to some extra colors which we can use by name. So here we are talking about if we want to use colors by name. Then using x11 options, we get access to some more color options, and this option is also only available in xcolor package. And now let's look at those colors which we have access to using these options. So these are the base colors. These 19 colors, as you can see, that they all start with the lowercase, black, blue, brown, and all these colors are always available. Then these are the dvipsname option colors. So if you use this option in the package xcolor or color, then you get access to these all these colors. And if you see here, all these start with a capital letter. There are some differences here if you look carefully. For example, this green is the lowercase green, and we have an uppercase green. So these two are different colors. Of course, there is no difference in black, but there are some differences in other colors. These are the svg name colors, lot of colors available. Then there are x11 names option, and you can see that list is even bigger than svg names. Variations of yellow, and similarly maroon variations, and you have lot of options. This way we can use hundreds of these colors by their names. Let's start using some of these colors, and then we will discuss how to define our own colors later in this lecture. So first of all, we have to use a package. So the color is the basic package. So I am using the color package and without any option. There is no option. So we get access to some basic colors. So let's say that we want to use red color. So I will say backslash color, and then in curly brackets, red with the lower key. And now if I compile this program, so text of all my document will be changed to red. So all this text has been changed to red. Similarly, you can use any color. And now if you want to use the capital red color with this, which could be different and which is accessible by using dvipsnames, if I compile like this, program will not compile because it cannot find the definition of this capital red. So we have to use the other option, which is dvipsnames option. So I will say use names dvipsnames, it's a comma. So then if I compile this, now you can get that I'm able to compile this program, and this red color is almost similar to that one. So let's say, for example, if I don't want to change the color of all of my text but only this line, so for that we can use a command called text color, and then we mention the text, color of the text which we want to change, and then we put start the curly brackets, and then whatever text we want to change the color of, we just put it within the curly brackets. And now if I compile, only the first line will be changed. In this way, you can change the color of any specific text. So let us say that we want to change the background color of the page. So there is a command for that which is called page color, and you put the color, for example, cyan. So this will change the background color of the page. So as you can see, the background color of the change has been changed. So now let us say that we want to define our own colors. In order to define our own colors, we must understand color models, because we will be defining colors based on one of these models. So there are two kind of models. So first of all, there are some proprietary models like Pantone and HKS colors. So these colors give you very predictable results when you print them. So the problem with colors is that when you print the color, what you see on the screen usually you don't get when you print that color. So these type of colors, the proprietary Pantone and HKS colors, they have been designed for these predictable results whenever you print on a cloth or on a paper. So what type of paper you are using, whether it's a coated paper or uncoated paper. So they have all type of variation. They will give you, okay, this is our coated color variation for this color. So they have certain books. So you buy those books and you look at the book color, and whatever you can see on that book color, you will get that color printed. So this will give you a predictable results on different mediums, whether it's a coated page, whether it's a cloth, whether it's uncoated page, it's a matte finish page, or it's a fine finish page. So you can get some predictable results by using these colors. Then these are the parameter based model. These three RGB, there are other models, but these three are most important. So therefore I'm mentioning only these three. So these three are called parameter based models, where you give the parameters of certain colors. So for example, RGB model is based on red, green and blue. So in this model, the white is shown as 111. So if you define this color, if you want to define the RGB color in LaTeX, you will just use this command, define color, / define color, then whatever name you want to give this color to. For example, this is my own color, so my color. Then you put the name of the model which you are using, so RGB. Then you give the variations of these red, green and blue as a decimal between 0 and 1. So 0.2, 0.8 and 0.22. So as you can see that there are indefinite options you can give here. This will be a certain color which we can see when you just print it. But this color you will only see on the screen. If you want the same result which you can see on print medium, then you don't use RGB model, because RGB will be printed differently. So if you are making a LaTeX document which will be printed later on, then your option is to use the CMYK model. Because CMYK model is the industrial printing model. This is used by the industrial printers. So in this way, use cyan, magenta, yellow and black. Black are the key, they call it key color. So we use cyan, magenta, yellow and black variations. And so therefore we have now four different options to give in this. So we can define the CMYK color like. And now what you see on the screen, most probably that color will be printed. But CMYK color space cannot give you as bright colors as available in RGB model, because these are light based colors. So you will see the difference when you use CMYK color. So if you are only using for web pages, your document for web pages, then you can use RGB colors or HTML colors. And for HTML colors, there are a lot of, if you, for example, you like any web page color, so you can use a Chrome extension like eyedropper. This is a Chrome extension. And this extension will capture the HTML code for that color. And then you can use that color in your LaTeX document by defining like this. You can define countless colors at your own, with your own names, and then you can use them in the same fashion as we have used the other color, like text color or page color, anything like that. So these are some of the models I wanted to highlight to you. So now let us say I define my own color. So what I will do, I will put define color, and then I can give any name, for example my color, and then I have to give the model name RGB, let's say. And then I have to give, for RGB model requires three parameters, so therefore I have to give three parameters. So 0.2, let's say 0.8 and 0.4. So these are the three parameters for RGB color, and now I have defined this my color, but because I'm not using at the moment, so why not use it for this first line of text? So instead of this red, I use this color name, which is my color. So I can use this name now. And now let's say remove this page color command. We have already seen that. And now if I compile this, and now as you can see that this is my color. So this is the color combination which I defined with my color, and this text has been changed to that color. So in this way you can define any color by using this define color command with different models, and then you can use that color. So let us define another color, define color second color, let's name it second color. And then we use the model CMYK this time. And then we have to give four parameters. So let us say 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, and 0.5. So these are the four parameters required. And now I use here second color. And see how it looks like. And here, as you can see, there is almost gray. So it's a variation of gray. And now let's change this to something else. 0.4. Let's say 0.1, 0.6, and 0.2, and see the difference. And now as you can see, now it is turning towards green. So now if you give this CMYK color to the company from where you are printing something, so they will be able to adjust their color of the inks so that they can get this color printed for you. So in this way you can define colors from various models and you can use them. So let's use xcolor package. So I just copy this and paste and change this to xcolor. So xcolor package gives us access to SVG names and the X11 names option. So let's say I want to use this khaki color as my page color. So I will use SVG names option. So I will use SVG names option. And then I can use khaki color as my page color. So backslash page color and then khaki. So now what I want to use is that my text color or my color of my alt text should be, let's say, brown. So I say color and I choose the brown which is available from the basic colors. So now as you can see that khaki is the page color and brown is the basic brown is the text color. And now let us say that I remove this color command, and now let's say I want to change only this text I want to highlight in a box. So I can also use a command called color box. Then I can assign the color for, let's say, green. And then I can assign this text. So this will put a box behind this text. And now as you can see that this text has been highlighted. So you can use it if you want to highlight a text. So there is another way to change the color of any text on the fly, and which is by using a command color. And then here, for example, I want this color to be 40% in green and rest black. So I will say green exclamation mark 40 exclamation mark black. And now, as you can see, that our text has been changed to 40% green and 60% black. This command color, this type of command you might see somewhere inside other LaTeX command, where the command is expecting a color to be input. So you can use backslash color in this way. You can immediately define a color and then put it in another LaTeX command. So this is a way to use the color as well. So there are some other packages now available which give access to Google colors, color designs, and some other colors. So you can have a look at those if you aren't really interested in some advanced topics. But normally we just define our own colors, or we use some of the existing colors, and this is enough for most of the LaTeX applications, because we have access to so many colors that there is no problem getting any colors we want. So if you want to get look and feel of some colors, so there is a website called latexcolor.com. So on this website there are a lot of colors available, so you can go through any of these colors and see what color you like for your document. And then there is a definition available for this. So this color, for example, has this RGB variations, and this is the HTML code for this color. So while putting the HTML code, you don't have to put this hash sign, just put the number. So in this way you can select any color and use them. So this is a very useful website, latexcolor.com. You might refer to this website. So these are some of the methods to use color. You can either use any of the packages like color or xcolor package with some options to get access to some other colors, or you can define your own colors using some of the color models available to us. And this way you can manipulate the document's look and feel. If you want to change the color of only the text, then you can use this text color command, and then with parentheses you can change whatever color you want. So I hope this will help you in using colors in LaTeX.